Hello dear, in this tutorial we will study about atoms, atomic number, mass number and atomic notation. So let's take a look first atom. What is atom? As we know, the atom consists of three subatomic particles, proton, neutron and electrons. Proton has a positive charge and neutron has a zero, neutral, they don't have any charge, and electron has a negative charge. So proton and neutron remain in the center of a nucleus, that center of an atom, that is called a nucleus, and electrons are around, they rotate around the nucleus, that is, and they form off in the cloud. So in an atom, usually number of proton remain equal to number of electron. That is why atom become neutral, it don't have any charge. But if number of electron changes, either low or high, then atom become an ion. So we will study about the ions in later video. And in the periodic table, each atom is characterized by its own number of proton. So each atom has its own characteristics, number of proton. So let's take a look about the atomic number, which is represented by Z. So the total number of protons in an atom is called its atomic number. So for an example, in periodic table you will see there are two numbers written. One is just above the element and another number, which is larger number, just below the element. So one, the number which is written on the just above the element is represent atomic number, its own atomic number, and this atomic number is represent the number of proton of an atom. So hydrogen has one proton, and in case of nitrogen it has seven proton. But here one thing is important: if in the reaction atom do not change number of proton, the reaction take place only by changing of number of electron. If somehow we will change the number of proton less than 7, then the atom will become carbon. So the atom changes their own characteristic totally. If number of proton increases from 7 to 8, the atom become oxygen atom. So similarly, you will see in each periodic in each element they have different characteristic number of proton, which is called atomic number. Copper has 29, zinc has 30, gallium has 31. So, and in the case of iron has 26. Let's see the mass number, which is represented by A. Mass number is defined as the total number of protons and neutron of an atom, that is called its mass number, which is represented by A. And atomic mass is a whole number. You will see the one number is below the proton here, which is 1.0079. This is not a mass number, this is a average atomic weight. So we will study about that average atomic weight or average atomic mass in later video. But the mass number is represented by total number of proton and total number of neutron, which is a whole number. For an example, hydrogen has atomic mass number of hydrogen has only 1, because it don't have any neutron. Mass number of copper is 59, which consists 27 proton, which is atomic number, and 32 proton. But you will see here the number is written here 58.933. This is average atomic mass, not mass number. So mass number is always a whole number. Let's see the atomic notation. What is atomic notation? Atomic notation is used to show the number of protons and neutron in an atom. How we will represent atomic number of proton and neutron in an element? So it's symbolized like this, S, where Sy is a symbol of atom, and A is mass number, which is proton plus neutron, and Z is atomic number, which is number of proton. So for an example, hydrogen will be represented like this, 1 upon 1, where it has only one proton in the mass number and zero neutron, and number of proton will be 1. In another example, boron is represented like this, 10 upon 5, where 10 is mass number and atomic number 5 is written in the bottom. And cobalt has 59 mass number and 27 atomic number. So let's see what other information we can get from the atomic notation. Atomic notation of cobalt, take an example here, which so first information we will get, the element is the cobalt symbol, which is represented by the symbol cobalt, and its atomic number is here 27. It means it has total 27 number of protons, and mass number is 59. It means the atom of cobalt has 59 protons and neutron. 59 total number of proton and neutron is 59, and the number of neutron in the cobalt is how we will calculate the number of neutron. So we can, if we will subtract mass number A minus Z atomic number, then we can get the value, which is 59 minus 27 is equal to 32 neutron. And one more thing, that we can also get the information about the electron in case of atom only, which is mass number, which is the number of electron will be equal to number of proton, which is Z, and 27 electron will have. So we will see some other examples of isotopes, isotopic atoms, so in the next video. And I hope you understand this atomic number and atomic mass here. Okay, thank you.